here are the topics I'm going to cover today. Fine. So our first topic will be logically solving questions. Second one, I'll tell you a direct method to identify whether a number, a fraction is terminating or recurring or pure recurring. Telpe assignment, baita assignment. Sorry. Right. Yeah. So our second topic will be about terminating decimals, recurring decimals. Third topic will be about perfect squares, identifying perfect squares. Then a little bit concept about square root, which is very important. I will show you the questions. 99% of the people will go wrong there. So there there is a need to explain a square root concept as well. Then we'll be discussing this cross multiplication thing, which is again an important concept. Then here sixth problem here, this one many people face problem, many people face difficulty while answering this kind of questions, because they do, I will show you those questions, they take lot of time, but I will tell you a technique wherein you can solve those questions hardly in 50 seconds, not more than that, right? Then sixth question, we will be decoding the real meaning of remainder, right? Remainder theorem. Then finally we will solve a few questions on fractions. So here are the questions. First of all, I will show you the questions, then so that you can gauge how our session is going to be, right? For next 1 hour. Now, right. This is the first question. Second one. Second. Third question. This one. This. Right? These are the questions. Right, these are the questions I'm talking about. Questions normally are like this, from 1 to 5000. How many numbers are divisible by 4 or 7? Or these kind of questions, right? So, right, so here you see this question is a very important and easy question, but again 99% of the people will fail to answer this question on time. If you are given enough time, 5 minutes, then everyone can answer this, but solving this question in less than a minute is a challenging task. Only when you have a clear cut concept you will be able to solve this one, right? So here are these questions, right? So let's get started with the first question. So thinking logically, so our first part is about thinking logically about solving the questions, right? So I'm starting the timer, maybe you people can try to answer this. I will give you exactly 50 seconds time, right? N is equal to, this number is given, so what is the value of root 10? Try to answer me, be proactive, okay? This session I want to make it as interactive as possible. And don't hesitate if you are getting answer, or if even if it is wrong, don't hesitate to message in chat. Okay, option A, fine, yeah, right, cool. So here it is, so N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these numbers if you see, they are very much nearer to each other, right? Unit of digit, no, unit digit, it won't help you really here, it actually may not help you. You have to check it anyway. It will be 5 here, then 5, 10, 0, 6. 6 means something 6, root of something 6 means you can have either 6 or 4 also. This is also possible, right? This is not possible, right? This one not possible. Don't go by unit digit. That is not the right logic. Because looking at the unit digit, if you take root of some number, if you have last number as 6, you cannot say what it will give you. You cannot say exactly, because if you take 14 square 196, 14 square will be 196, right? Now see here, the units digit here is 6, but looking at this 6, you cannot say that your square also will be 6. Here it is actually 4, right? So that doesn't help you. Don't go by units number. See here, the numbers proximity, they are very much near, right? So what you can do is take this number as x, right? X. So this will be x square, plus this is also x, and this will be x plus 1, right? Plus x plus 1. So if you simplify this, x square plus 2x plus 1. Now you know the formula, right? This is of a perfect square form. So this can be written as x plus 2 whole, x plus 1 whole square, right? So that when you expand this, you'll get back this a square plus b square plus 2ab, right? So your number n is equal to x plus 1 whole square. So root of n, if you take a root on both sides, what happens is this root and this square will get cancelled, and then you will get n is equal to x plus 1. Now, so your answer is root n value will be equal to x plus 1. So your answer is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, right? This is an easy question. So let's solve our next one. This one. Again, I'm starting the timer. Which is not a perfect square? You have to answer this. D, okay. Right. Only one person answered. So let me solve this. Normally how you approach with these kind of questions is, looking at these options, I am unable to eliminate anything. So soon what you have to do is, you should be in a position to cancel out like this. This will be 7, 9, 4, 4, 8, 1, 7. Then again 9, 7, 8, 9, 2, 3. And this will be 1. So again this will be 7, 7, 4, right? So it may be 1, 4, 7, 9. So answer will be either this one or these two things, which is not a perfect square. So your answer will be C. That's it. How much time did I take to solve this? Hardly 30 seconds, not more, not even 30 seconds. It's 20 seconds question, right? So here is the concept I'll tell you. See here, whenever you are working on perfect squares, you have to identify a perfect square, there are three simple rules. First rule is, if you take any perfect square, I'll show you some examples here. One is a perfect square, right? One is a perfect square. Two, when you say 2 square, it is a 4. 4 is a perfect square. 9 is a perfect square. 4 square is 16. 16 is a perfect square. 25, 36, 49, right? 64. All these are perfect squares. Now, if you observe these things, this units digit, what happens is, no, actually, the see, I cannot say that, but looking at the options, I can eliminate that. See this. Let me check this. 9014 root. It is not a perfect square, right? Actually, the options are wrong. It should be something different number, which should be a perfect square, right? So normally, if you are asked these kind of questions, what happens is the questions will be asked only on this logic. So I framed this question, right? I framed on my own. So I made some calculation mistake here while calculating the number. So this number should ideally be a perfect square. Let me come to that point. So if you observe this pattern, the units digit you are finding 1 or 4 is there, units digit 9 is there, 6 is there, 5 is there. So what are the numbers missing? 2, 3, 7, 8, right? Let me check. So first let me complete this. I will check the options, right? So 2, 3, 7, 8. So your first rule is, to identify a perfect square, the units digit should not have 2 or 3 or 7 or 8, right? Agree with this? Because if you see any perfect square's units digit, you won't have 2, 3, 7, 8. So, first of all, if you see 2, 3, 7, 8 at the end units digit, that is not a perfect square. Then, one more requirement of perfect square is, observe the digital sum here. Distal sum of 1 is 1, distal sum of 4 is 4, this is 9. Distal sum of 16 is, distal sum is nothing but if you have number 1, 2, 3, add all these numbers, okay, you will get a double digit. Again add them, you will get a single digit. So your target is make a number to single, that will be a single digital sum. So here digital sum is 7, here digital sum 7, here digital sum 9, here digital sum 9 plus 4 is 13, again 1 plus 3 is 4. So this one 6 plus 4 is 10, again 1 plus 0 is 1. So if you observe this pattern, your digital sum in a perfect square should be either 1, 4, 7, 9. Only these things, right? So these two rules are very important. And there is one more rule, third rule. Third rule is again crucial. 90% of the questions you can solve using only these two rules. But then if you fail to use these rules, then you have to go with this, right? Now see this. Third rule is check for last two digits. You take any perfect square, last two digits will be equal to the last two digit of any two digit 25 numbers, 25 squares, right? So what I'm saying is you have to memorize squares till 25, okay? That will be very useful in your exam. So always try to memorize till 25 squares, at least till 30 squares, right? So what I'm saying is you take any big number, their square, last two digits of any perfect square will be matching with any of these perfect 25, top 25 perfect squares, okay? That is a rule here. Now I'll tell you how to identify last two digits of any perfect square, okay? Given any perfect square, you will be able to identify the last two digits very easily. I'll tell you the technique. Now for this question, let's use these two logics and solve this question. As I told you, units should not have 2, 3, 7, 8. Here, nowhere 2, 3, 7, 8 is there. So there are chances that all these are perfect squares. Okay, might be this question I might be framed wrongly. These options. Let me check here. Now we will go through digital sum. So what is the digital sum of this? I have made a video on digital sum. You can check that right in our Spartans GRE videos. You can check that. Now I will do fast here. Wherever you are getting 9, you can cancel it, right? Because in 9 plus anything, distal sum will be depending on this anything number, any number, other number, right? Now you see here, I'm cancelling 9. I'm 4, 5 plus 4 is 9. I'm cancelling it again. 5 plus 2 is 7. I got distal sum 7. So there are chances that this is a perfect square. Actually, I will check it whether it is a perfect square or not, because I framed this question. So there are chances I might go somewhere wrong here. Right, this is a perfect square. Fine. This is a perfect square. Now this one. Again, check for digital sum. 9 I will cancel. 4 plus 4 is 8. From 2 I will take 1. So it will be 9. Cancel it. 1 will be remaining here. 6 plus 1 is 7. So here also digital sum I am getting 7. So again there are chances this is a perfect square. Let me check it. 6, 2, 0, 9, 4 root is a perfect square, right? Here it is a perfect square. Now this is also not our answer. So this one, 9 I cancel, 7 plus 1, 8, I will give 1, I will take 1 from 4, it will become 9, so I can cancel it. Remaining will be 3 here, right? Now 7 plus 3 is 10, so 10 plus 1 plus 0 is 1, distal sum I got as 1. I can have 1, 4, 7, 9. Right, so this can be our answer, but not answer, because this might be also perfect square. So tick it. I'll check it here whether this is a perfect square or not. 7, 1, 7, 4, 0, 9 square root. This is also a perfect square, right? Now what is the distal sum of this one? 9 I cancel, 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, so I'm getting 4. So this is also having a distal sum of 4. There is chances that this is also a perfect square, right? Yeah. Now see here, we are asked to find which is not a perfect square, right? So this is a chances this is a perfect square, perfect square, perfect square. This is also chances that is perfect square. Now how will you eliminate your option? Now start using your logic 3. This is very important. Maybe to explain you this logic 3 only, I framed the options that way. So options are not wrong, right? Right, this is a good question again. So I made it purposefully tough, okay? Most of the majority of the questions asked in GRE, they are using the rule 1 and rule 2, you can crack it. But this is a difficult question. So here you need to apply your rule 3 as well, right? Till now everyone understood, right? Using rule 1 and rule 2, we are unable to find the answer because I'm getting this is a perfect square, this is perfect square, this is perfect square, this is also a perfect square because their digital sum is falling under 1479. Till now everyone understood? Digital sum is nothing but you have to add all the numbers. The video is there in our channel, so you can watch that. Now, because I have many models to cover, right? Session will otherwise take more than 2 hours. So let's make it fast. Digital sum is nothing but make all the numbers. After this session, I will post you that link as well. All the numbers, you add them. You have to get only single digit. That is called digital sum. Now, see here, using digital sum, you are unable to answer. Now the rule is, third one, I told you last two digits of any perfect square should be falling in last two digits of any perfect square from 0 to 25, 1 to 25, right? Now see here, if I take 1 square, it will be 1. 2 square is 2. I'll write it here because actually I know perfect square is still 30. Everyone should know that. You have to memorize that. 2 square, 3 square is 9, 4 square 16. I'll write it here 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, 100, 121, and 12 square, 144, 13, 169, 14, 196, 15, 225, 16, 256, 17, 289, 18, 324, 19, 361, 20, 400, 21, 441, 484, 22, 23, I'll keep it aside, 24 square, suppose if I forgot 24 square, soon I will write it as 4 plus 4 to the right 16, 4 plus 16, 6, 7, 5, 76. So I know some shortcut regarding perfect squares. Anyway, that is not needed for GRE. So again, 23 square means 12, 9 I will write, 9 to 5, this will be 5 to 9. Okay, so these are the perfect squares, right? These are the perfect squares till 25. Now if you observe the last two digits, see here, last two digits, right? Now these are the last two digits. Now you see, take any number. I'm taking, suppose I will take 73, right? What is my 73? If I want to know the last two digits of 73, now listen the concept carefully, because this concept will be useful in further questions. I'll show you the question. If I want to know the last two digits of 73, what you have to do is, you take your base as 50, okay? Always your base is 50. And you should know, the precondition is, you should know square still 25 square, right? Now, what is 73? 73 means from 50, you have to go 23 ahead, right? So, what I can say is, the last two digits of 73 square will be equal to last two digits of 23 square. You can check that, I'll show you. What is this 73? From base 50, you go 23 forward, you will get 73. So what I am saying is, last two digits of 73 square will be equal to last two digits of 23 square. I will check it here. See here, 73 into 73 will be 5329, right? What about 23 into 23? 23 into 23, 529. So last two digits, see, it got satisfied, right? Last two digits is 29. Similarly, I will take some other number. You can give me, otherwise you people can give me some number, because I just want to know whether everyone is properly listening to my lecture. I just want you people, any person can give me a number, right? Okay, so 40 is very easy number, right? Because anyway, 40 means last two digits will be 0 only. So if I take 50, enough. Okay, I'll take some number, 51 and 86. If I take 51 means it is your base should be 50. Your bases should be like this. Base should be either 50 or 100, right? It should go in multiples of 50 or 100. Your base should go either 50, 100 or in multiples of 50 and 100, okay? Now, 51 square means it is one more than 50, right? So your last two digits of 51 will be equal to the last two digits of 1 square. What is the last digit of 1 square? It is 01, right? You have to take 0 here because you're considering last two digits. See here, so 51 square, you will get 01. CH01, right? Similarly, I'll take one more number, 86. 86, if you see, 86 is how much more than 50? It is 36 more than 50, right? So you're getting a bigger number. Then again, what you have to do, 36 square last digit will be equal to 15 minus 14, right? So making it big. So take the nearest number. Now take for 100. 86 is how much less than 100? It is 14 less than 100, right? So 86 square last two digits will be equal to 14 square last two digits. So 14 square last two digit, I know 196. So 86 square last two digits will be equal to 96. That's it. So see here, I'll show you. 86 into 86 will give you 7396. So last digit will be 96, right? What if the number is less than, I'm not getting you here, less than 50? That's what, suppose your number is take it 47, right? Number is 47, your base is 50. Now I want to know last two digits of 47 square. How much less than 50? It is 3 less than 50, right? So 47 square will have last two digits equal to last two digits of 3 square. So here you can check again. 47 into 47, your last digit will be 09. That's it, right? You got it? Everyone got it? Suppose I'll take one more bigger number. I want to know 231, right? What I'll do is 231, I'll take base as multiples of 50 and 100. If I take base as 100, it will be 200. So it is 30 more than 200, right? 30 more than 200. Again, 30 is nearer to 15. So it is 19 less than 15. So 19 squares last two digits will be equal to 231 whole squares. So 231 whole square last two digits will be 61, right? I can check it here. 231 into 231. So it should be 61. Understood, everyone? Right? So this is an easy logic. Now you see here, first option you see 49 is there. So there are chances that this might be a perfect square. See here, 49. So this number, last two digits of any number should fall under, should be equal to some last two digits of first 25 squares, right? So this is fine. 44, you see, in 144, 12 square is 144. So there we have 44, this is fine. 09, in 3 square we are having last digit as 09, so that is also fine. If you see 14, can you find 14 anywhere here? Nowhere last two digits are 14, right? I don't want you to write all these squares in the exam. So that's the reason why I ask you to memorize squares till 30. Not even 30, 25 is fine. So that as soon as you see the number 14, you will soon identify that 14 is nowhere in the last two digits, right? So D is not a perfect square. That is your answer, right? You need not open calculator and check it. 719014 square root. That is not a perfect square, right? So this is how you have to answer this question. Don't take the calculator and manually write all these numbers and check it. Okay, in case if they give some 9-digit number, then you are gone. Okay, because in exam calculator can hold maximum of 8 digits. So there is no way that you can type the number there. So you should know all these rules. These are the basic rules, right? So this is how a perfect square works. So identify perfect squares. I told you two rules, right? Again, see 231. That is fine. See here, this 250 minus 19 is also fine, because there you are taking base as 250. 250 is also multiple of 50, right? So instead of doing all this, right, 250 minus 19, again, that is a big calculation. You don't have time in your exam. So what I'm saying is, how I calculated is 231. I can take 100 base also, right? If I take 100 as base, 100 into 2 will be 200. So 200, I can cancel them completely. Now I'm left with only 31. 31 means again I can take 50 as base, right? So 19 will be, so 31 square will be equal to 19 square. That's it. Decimal number will not be a perfect square, right? In perfect squares, you will not get a decimal number, right? If at all you see some option where decimal is there, straight away you can cancel it. Decimals will not be a perfect square at all, right? Now you people solve this question. I'm starting the timer now. someone asked me about digital sum, right? So I know you might not have seen that video on digital sum. I uploaded already in our channel. So here is the channel, people who don't know that. You go to YouTube and type this, you'll get a shield. Shields symbol, red color shield, that will be our channel. Go to number systems playlist, there you will find about the digital sum concept, right? Anyway, after this session I will post that link as well, but I won't be posting this video, so listen carefully and participate. Okay, participate actively, right? Okay, I'll solve this, which is not a perfect square. Now you know, okay, let's see. Now you know again, 2, 3, 7, 8 should not be in a units digit. Nowhere it is there, 2, 3, 7, 8. So using that, we cannot eliminate. Now go by digital sum logic, or else what you can do is there any number which is having last two digits perfect square? This one, this is fine. This is anyway not okay. So go by digital sum. 7, 9, 9 cancel, cancel. 7, 3, 13. It will be 4. And this will be 7, 2, 4 will be there, 4 and 7, 7, 1 you give, this will be 7, and this will be 2 give, 4, 2 you give, 5, and 4 you give, 3, this will be 9, and this one will be this and this 9, 7, 9, 6. So all these are having 1, 3, 4, 7 is there, right? Yeah, right. So your answer will be D, that's it, right? Now, we'll move on to our next question. See this. Now can anyone answer me this question? Don't use calculator because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 numbers are there, I think. Yeah, 10 numbers are there. Anyway, in your exam, you can't use your calculator to calculator to find the answer for this. But at home, since you are online, you can use your calculator, but please don't use it. Try to answer me this question. I'll give 30 seconds. At least I need a hint. E, okay. Everywhere you are able to see 7 and 3, right? Because 7 square last digit will be 9, 3 square also last digit will be 9. Okay. One person said A. See here, in case in your exam, if this question is given, the question will be based on only one logic that I am going to tell now, because nowhere you can solve this question without using calculator or through only you can solve this question two ways. One is by manual method and second is by calculator. So alright, how you people are saying A? What is the logic there? Hmm. 13 into 13, 69. Okay. Hmm. Right. Correct. Right. Good. Hmm. Right. So whatever logic I explained earlier, right? Using that logic you solve, which is very good. That should be the right strategy. See here, some answer should be square, right? This whole square will give you this number, right? So if I want to find my last two digits, last two digits are 69. So here last two digits are what? If I take multiples of thousands also, I will get 80,000. Again 9,787 will be there. Again I take it multiples of 100 or thousands, it will be, finally I will end up with 87 here. 87 means 13 less than 100. 13 square last digit, so that should be 69. So your answer will be A. That is the logic here, right? Now I'll tell you one more observation. You take any perfect square, what you have to do is, suppose if I take root 144, what will be my answer? It will be 12, right? Now see here, whenever you are having a perfect square, do one thing. From left you start marking your this one, marking two digits, You mark this one, right? Or else see this. Fine. So the logic, earlier logic you understood, right? How to find the last two digits. Using last two digits logic, you will able to say this one. Now you see here, what you have to do is mark these two two numbers. Total how many blanks you have? Total 5 blanks are there, right? So your answer should have 5 digits. So your answer will be A. That's it. Okay. Now you similarly you take 144. You mark from here, from right to left. You mark. Okay. You are having how many blanks? 2 blanks, right? So your maximum number will be 2. That's it. So your answer will be 2. Similarly, you take any number. Suppose any number you take, right? You understood, right? Just make them 2, 2, 2. How many dashes you will have, that many numbers will be there in the square root. That's it. That is one logic. And to make the question even further, this one, right? This particular sum you are saying, this one. Okay, that's what. If in option every number is 5 digit, then you have to go by, that means the question is made even further difficult, then you have to use last two digits logic. The first logic for this should be count number of dashes. Take them as pairs, okay? Pairs. There are 5 pairs, right? 5 pairs. You have to come like this side. This side you have to come. Right? 5 pairs are there, so your answer should have 5 digits. So if at all in options all are 5 digits, then you have to go by your last 2 digits. How you will go by last 2 digits? See here, you know this root of this one is a perfect square. That is why every number is an integer. There is no decimals here. So that means this is a perfect square. Now, so that means your answer square root, when you square your answer, that will give you this number, right? Correct, na? So what I'm saying is, I will try to find the last digit of this whole square. Try to find the last digit of this, last two digits of this whole square, that should give me 69. So if I take 89787 whole square, I want to find what are my last two digits. That last two digits should give me 69. So what I'm doing is, I should take my base as multiples of 50 or 100, right? So here 89,787 is there. So I will take my base as how much? 80,000 directly. So 80,000 is a multiple of 100, right? So this number I can write it as 80,000 plus 9787, right? Now again, I can take my base as 1000. So it will be 9000 plus 787. 9000 plus 787. Again, I will take, if I go on like this, right, you will get it 87. Anyway, last two digits, you will get it as 87. 87 is 13 less than 100. So 87 whole square, this will be equal to 13 whole square, last two digits, not whole thing. So 87 whole square should give me 69 as a last two digits. So that means this whole square, you will get this number. That's it, right? This is how the earlier logic which I told you, that is useful here. Now tell me this question. This is a difficult question, but then I'm very sure you'll be able to solve this question now. I'm starting the timer. There's nothing to find the last digit. What you have to do is take the last two digits. That is fine. Take the last two digits and apply the logic whichever I told earlier. The question is x is something square plus something square plus something square. What is the sum of the digits in the units place and the tens place of x? Right. Don't worry if the session is fast. Actually, I'm purposefully going a bit fast because I need to cover many models. That's why I'm going a bit fast. Okay. 15 B D. Okay. So majority people are going with option D, right? So that is right. That is right. See here, what you'll do is this whole square. The question is, what is the sum of unit digit and tens digit of x? So after simplifying this number, you will get a big number, right? There he is asking the last two digit sum. So the question is actually asking to find the last two digits and add the numbers. What I will do is, what is the last two digits of this one? This one will be just take 87, last two digits you take. This number, this bigger numbers of whole square will have last two digits equal to last two digits of 87 square itself. So what is the last two digits of 87 square? 87 is 13 less than 100. So 13 square's last two digits will be equal to last two digits of 87 square. So 13 square is 169. So this will be 69. Right? This one again, take 82. 82 is 18 less than 100, right? 18 less than 100. So 18 square is 324. So this will be 24. Again, take this 50 plus 24. 24 square is how much? 526, right? 24 square is 4, 8, 16, yeah, 576, yeah. 24 square is 576. 24 into 24, 576, right? So last two digits will be 76. Now I got my last two digits, 69 plus 24 plus 76, add them. 9 plus 13, this will be 19, 1, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 plus 7, 16, 169. So you take last two digits for x will be 69, that's it. So your answer will be 6 plus 9, which is 15, that's it. So your answer is 15, right? Right, good that you people were able to solve this. So let's move on to next question. See this, when to take base 50 or 100, how to decide? See, if you want to calculate last two digits for a number less than 50, okay, anyway, see here, I asked you to memorize till 25. Till 25, you should know. There is no logic to say for till 25, okay? 1 to 25 perfect squares, you should be knowing this, right? Now, 50 is there here. Now, whichever perfect squares falling from 25 to 50, then take 50 as the base. Again, see here, 1 to 25, 50 here. And 100 is here, above 100. What you will do is, whatever numbers, you know these things, right? Now, whatever number falls from 25 to 50, for them take base as 50. Now, whichever number falls from 50 to 100, there also you take base as 50 or 100, depends on number is near to 50 or near to 100, right? Now, again, whichever number is more than 100, take always base as 100. Or simple, what you will do is, just take the last two digits, right? Take the last two digits of the given number and check whether that number is, suppose if I want to say 12357 whole square, I want last two digits, so I'll take just 57. Again, 57 squares last two digit will be equal to the last two digits of 7 square, because 57 is 7 nearer to 50. If here 43 is there, then also it will be 7 near to 50, right? 43 will be falling here, 47 will be falling here. 43 you will take base as 50, that's it. Okay, fine. Now let's solve this question. You people try to answer me this and don't use calculator again. Don't use calculator. Starting the timer now. What I am doing is 50 plus 24, so 24 square will have 576, right? So last two digits of 24 square, so that will be 76. Okay, A, D, fine. Now this question, I can answer this in 1 second, not more than that. Just 1 second. This one you didn't get? This one? You're saying this? Okay. See here, 23782 whole square is there, right? To find the last two digits of this one, just take the last two digits. Last two digits is what? 82. So this numbers, this particular numbers squares last two digits will be equal to the just last two digits of 82 square. Okay, now to find it, don't draw anything here, you can't erase it again, okay? Don't try anything here, right? Now 82 square is there, right? Now 82 means this number take base as 100, then 82 is how much less than 100? 18 less than 100, right? When you take base as 100, that means 82 squares last two digits will be equal to 18 squares last two digits. What is 18 square? 18 square is 324. So last two digits is 24. That's why I got 24 here, right? Now, and people said A, so no one is able to answer this, A or D. Let's check that. See how we will solve this question is, this is simple in terms of 3. So this is a perfect recurring. So your answer will be this. That's it. Hardly 1 second. So here is the concept. See here. There are two kinds of numbers. One is terminating decimal, right? So this is terminating decimal. Terminating decimal will be of the form 0.A something like this, right? 0 point something A, B, C, something like this. There won't be any recurring. Now, there will be something called perfect recurring. Perfect recurring. What is the meaning of recurring? Recurring is nothing but some number is repeating, right? So that is called recurring. How will you indicate recurring? If I say 0.6 bar, that means 6 is repeating multiple times. That means 0.6666, this number is recurring. That's why instead of writing all these things, I'll write here 0.6 and put a bar on top of 6, right? That is called perfect recurring. Perfect recurring will be of the form 0.abc, bar will be on complete number, right? Now there is something called mixed recurring. Mixed recurring. Mixed recurring will be of the form like this, 0.23555, something like this. That means only 5 is getting recurring and 2 and 3 are not getting recurred, right? So that will be of the form 0.abc and bar will be on maybe on bc or maybe on c alone, right? So these are the formats. Now you have to know the basic rule to identify a terminating decimal. Your answer will depend on the denominator itself. So you take any fraction. First of all, take any fraction and simplify the fraction. Simplify the fraction. What I mean to say by simplify is, if I have a number like 6 by 24, don't just blindly take 24. First, you have to simplify the number. How will you simplify? You will make it as 1 by 4, right? Now you have to check it. I'll tell you. Don't worry. Now see here, first step is simplify the fraction. See whether the fraction is in simplified form. Now 13 by 81, it is in a simplest form, right? So no issues. Move further. Second rule is, whenever you are having decimal, terminating decimal, your denominator will be having only 2s or 5s or combinations of 2 and 5. If you are able to see your denominator in terms of only 2s or 5s or both combination of 2 and 5, then that is called terminating decimal. Now, if your denominator do not have 2 is not there, 5 is not there, neither 2 or 2 and 5 multiples are there, then it is perfect recurring. If your denominator is having 2 or 5 or 2 and 5 along with some other number, then that is called mixed recurring. That means bar will be something like this. See here, this is a mixed recurring. Mixed recurring means some numbers will have bar, some numbers will not have bar. And see here, all the numbers are having bar after decimal. So this is a perfect recurring. This is a mixed recurring. This is a perfect recurring. Mixed recurring. This is a terminating decimal. This is a terminating decimal, right? So this, what is the number here? Yeah, this is a terminating decimal, right? Now, till now everyone understood, right? These rules, everyone understood? Right? Everyone understood this? Simple. First thing is, when you are trying to find, okay, I'll repeat again. When you are trying to find whether a fraction is decimal or not, first thing is you have to simplify the fraction. See here, 13 by 81, is it simplified or not? Is there any number which can cancel both? There is no other number, right? So 13 by 81 is fine. Now go ahead. What I am saying is, there are actually four type of decimals. One is terminating decimal, one is non-terminating decimals. I am writing here. One is terminating, one is non-terminating. Terminating means it is fine. The number game is over there. Non-terminating means there can be recurring or non-recurring. This won't be asked in exam. Non-recurring cannot be asked in framing such questions. So now you have only recurring. Again, this recurring can be of two types. One is perfect recurring, another is mixed recurring. Right? What is perfect recurring? Perfect recurring means 0 point some number will be there, right? Something like 0.73. If you have bar on both the numbers, that is called perfect recurring. That means your number will be 0.73, 7373 and so on. That is perfect recurring. What is mixed recurring? Mixed recurring of the form 1.73535, like this 35, only 35 is repeating. That means this can be written as 0.735. Bar should be written on only on top of 35, because 35 is only getting repeated. That is called mixed recurring. What is terminating decimal? Terminating decimal means none of the numbers will get repeated and the number terminates there. Right? Now I am telling this is the core logic. I am telling you how to identify terminating decimal, perfect recurring or mixed recurring. The thing is, your answer will entirely depend on the denominator itself, given denominator. So pick this one. What I am saying is, you should factorize this number first of all. After factorizing that number, if you are able to write that 81 in terms of, suppose 81 you take, when you factorize what you will get? 9 into 9 is 81. Again, 9 means 3 square into 3 square. That means 3 power 4. Right? So, 81 means 3 power 4. Right? 81 means 3 power 4. That means your 81 can be written only in terms of 3. Right? That means there is no 2, there is no 5, there is no multiples of 2 and 5. So, this number falls under pure recurring, perfect recurring. Okay? Perfect recurring. Perfect recurring means, I told you how it is identified, bar should be placed on all the numbers. So your answer will be A. Now you got it. I'll give you one more example. See here. I'll give you one more example. Now, tell me whether 7 by 24 falls under terminating or recurring or perfect recurring or mixed recurring. Tell me which one it falls. 7 by 24, is it a terminating decimal or is it a perfect recurring or is it mixed recurring? Tell me your answer. Non-terminating, okay. No, actually there is nothing like non-terminating that won't be asked. So your answer should be either perfect recurring or mixed recurring. Recurring, that is fine, but I want perfect recurring or mixed recurring, because that decides your answer, because based on that logic only you will be able to eliminate your options. See here, take 24, okay? Now stop typing there, take 24. 24, how can you write? 6 into 4, right? Again, 6 means 3 into 2, 4 is 2 square. So when you factorize 24, you will be able to write it as 2 cube into 3, right? So that means you are able to write your number, this denominator, in terms of 2s and 3. That means you are not able to write this number only in terms of 2 or not just in terms of other numbers, but there is a mix of 2 is there, right? That means it comes under mixed recurring. So your answer will be of this form, 0.ABC of this form, bar will be of something else. Like you take this one, 7 by 24. So see here, your calculator, it is putting 7 here. So your actual answer will be 2.916666. So the bar may be on 66. So your answer will be 0.AB, bar will be on like this, right? So in your answer, right, mixed and terminating means, I'll tell you, I'll give you one more example. You tell me answer for this. 7 by 125. Tell me, is this a recurring or non-recurring number? 7 by 125. Yeah, I'll tell that. See here. I'm asking, what is 7 by 125? Your first step should be, you simplify 7 by 125. So 7 by 125, there is no term, common term to cancel them, so leave it as it is. Now take the denominator. 125 means you can write it as 5 cube, right? So 5 cube. That means you are able to write your denominator in terms of just 5. You can either check with 2 or 5 or both 2 and 5. Here you are having only 5. That means this is a perfect terminating. So this is a terminating number. You can check it here. 7 by 125 will give you 0.056. That's it. Right? It is not recurring. It is a terminating number. Right? Now I will give you one more number. Or else we have a question here, I think. Yeah. You tell me for this. Okay, see here, what I'm saying is 7 by 125, I asked you whether this is a terminating decimal or recurring decimal, right? What did I say? Check the decimal denominator. Denominator 125 can be written as 5 cube, right? So that means you are able to write 125 just in terms of 5, right? I told you in terminating decimal, the denominator should either be a multiple of 2 or 5 or combination of 2 and 5, then it will be terminating. If there is no 2 involved, no 5 involved, no 2 and 5 involved, then that means 2 is not there, 5 is not there, or neither 2 and 5 multiples are there, then it is called perfect recurring. If there is at least 1, 2 and some other number, then that is called mixed recurring. Right? Now see here, 5 cube is there, right? That means only 5 is there. That means this 7 by 125 is a terminating decimal. Just to show example, just to prove you, I said I calculated here, I got 0.056. 0.056 is a terminating number, right? There are no decimal, no numbers after 6. Now you see here, this one. 8 by 27, first step, simplify the fraction. Then 8 by 27, nothing is there to cancel in numerator and denominator. Now choose the denominator. 27 can be written as 3 cube. Now here you see no 2 is involved, no 5 is involved, no multiples of 2 and 5 is involved, only 3 is involved. So when only 3 is involved, not just 3, you take any number other than 2 and 5, that means that is a perfect recurring. So your answer should be in the form of like this. The bar should be there on all the numbers, whichever is there after decimal. So your answer will directly be 0.296. That's it, right? This is how you have to eliminate your options. Suppose, see, this is one of the questions asked by some person in the group, okay? So you find the answer for this. This is a question from maybe some standard book, but there how they calculated the answer is, they said the answer by using calculator everywhere. If you are having F till F, if you keep opening the calculator and start pressing the buttons, right, it will take hell lot of time, okay? It will screw up your exam completely. People will take at least 2 minutes to do all these things. Don't do that mistake. Now answer me this one. Yeah, 8 by 27, you see here, 8 by 27. 27 can be written as 3 cube, right? 3 cube. What is this 3? 3 cube. That means 27 you are writing only in terms of 3. That means there is no 2 involved. Check whether 2 and 5 is involved. No 2 is involved. No 5 is involved. Only 3 is involved. So it is a perfect recurring. That means it will be in the form of like this. The bar should be there on all the numbers. Don't worry, I'll give you one more example. Just be patient here. Now see here. Which of the following are terminating decimals? What did I say terminating decimal means? First of all, the fraction should be simplest form, in their simplest form. Next rule is the denominator should have either only in multiples of 2 or in multiples of 5 or in multiples of both 2 and 5, right? That is called terminating decimal. Now see here, this 8, 17 by 8, that is completely fine. No, nothing is there to cancel. That is it's in simplest form. So 8 you can write as a 2 cube. So this is a terminating decimal. So A is correct. 125, you can write it as 5 cube. Only 5, it is 125 is written as only 5 multiples. So this is also correct. Right? Again, 137 by 50. 50 can be written as 25 into 2. 25 means 5 square into 2. So 50 is written as only in terms of 2 or 5, right? What I am saying is terminating decimal means the denominator should only be able to be written in 2s or 5s or combination of 2 and 5. That's it. No other number should be there. Here only 2s and 5s are there. So this is also terminating. C is also correct. Here you see 32 can be written as 2 power 5. So this is also terminating. Now this one. 69 means you will write something as, and here you see don't solve it like this blindly. First you simplify it. 27 means 3 9s are, 3 2s are, 3 3s are. 9 by 23 is there. 9 by 23 means you, this 23 can be written as 23 into 1. That's it, right? That is a prime number. So this will be pure recurring or perfect recurring. Fine, that's why you see here, I'll show you 27 by 69, you'll get a perfect recurring. See, the perfect recurring will be actually this won't be asked anyway, because by this we can clearly tell maybe somewhere else it will get repeated, all the number will be repeated, or else that number is non-terminating non-recurring number. Understand? Non-terminating non-recurring, I told you fourth category, right? That won't be asked in your exam. How can you explain perfect recurring, mixed recurring and terminating again? Let me complete this session, then I will explain, okay? Don't worry, if we have time, I will take it at the end, okay? So because people shouldn't get bored, right? So let's move further, we have a lot more to discuss. So this is a perfect recurring, and if you see this 18 by 69, even this is here also, there no multiples of 2 is there, right? Only 13 into 3 is there. So this is also perfect recurring, that's it. So answer will be A, B, C, D, right? Don't use calculator for such questions, it's a waste of time. Now I'll explain this recurring topic again to people who have doubt. You can once the session is over, you stay back, I will explain it, right? Now answer me this, I'm starting the timer. Answer me this question. Root of 1 minus root 3 whole square plus root of root 3 minus 2 whole square. What will be the answer? You shouldn't take that much time actually. You should be able to answer it. Okay. Minus 1. Anyone else? Yes. People are falling in the trap. This is a trap question. Until unless you know the clear cut concept of a square root, you will not be able to answer this question. Simple cut root and square. Okay. That's what everyone will do this. To solve this question, and people will answer minus 1. Right. Let's see this. Now, first of all, understand the concept of square root, right? I told you, see here, always square root will give you positive result only. Square root will always return positive, never it will return negative. But you may ask me, if I have square root of x square is equal to 36, then you will say x is equal to plus or minus 6. Where did this minus come from, right? Here, if you observe this, x square is equal to 36, if you write it in terms of equation means what? Whichever thing you equate to 0, that is called equation. So equate it to 0, so bring 36 this side, that will be an equation. So what is this equation called? Quadratic equation, right? Quadratic equation, how will you find the roots? There is a formula, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Now you plug in the values here, then you will get something like minus b plus or minus root is there, right? This root will always give positive result only. This minus 6 is there, right? That minus is coming from this one. So every quadratic equation will have two roots, right? It will have two roots. Why? Because I told in graphs also, the graph will cut x-axis at two places. So you will have two roots. Now the second root, maximum of two roots, okay? The second root, you will get negative because of this formula here. This minus will be that one, but this square root will always give the positive result only. This you should etch this thing in your memory, okay? Etch this into your mind. Square root will give always positive. Now if I ask you, what is x is equal to root 36, what is my x value? X value here only 6 is correct, minus 6 will be wrong. See here, x square, when I wrote as 36, then you are getting x as plus 6 or minus 6, because this is a quadratic equation. And here if you see, this is a linear equation. X is equal to root 36 means x minus root 36 will be equal to 0. This is a quadratic linear equation, and linear equation will have only one root. That means your answer will be x is equal to 6 and minus 6 is wrong. So this is the concept behind square root. Now apply it here. See here, don't just blindly cancel these things until unless you know this term is a positive term, right? So what I'm saying is, whenever you have, suppose I'll tell you this one first of all, a minus b whole square, I will say this is equal to, or else see this, okay, see this, I can write this as, this will be a square b minus a whole square. Do you agree this is right or wrong? A minus b whole square equal to b minus a whole square. Is this correct or wrong? It is correct, right? Why? Because if you expand this, it will be a square plus b square minus 2ab. And if you expand this one, it will be b square plus a square again minus 2ab. Both are equal, correct? So a minus b can be written as b minus a, okay? Just underline this one, this statement. Now I will use this statement and I will solve this question. See this. I said root should always give me positive result, but what is happening here? 1 minus root 3, root 3 means 1.73 something, so 1 minus 1.73 will give me a negative number, right? So square root of negative number, so this number should not yield a negative result, it should yield a positive result for me. So how will I rewrite this statement is, I told you 1 minus root 3 whole square is also equal to root 3 minus 1 whole square, right? There is no change. If I take this as a, this as b, this will be a. I told you a minus b whole square will be equal to b minus a whole square. So what I will do is, to make this number as positive, that means the number given in the question is wrong. That it shouldn't be written this way. It should actually be written like this, root 3 minus 1 whole square, right? Okay, fine. Now you see this number. Root 3 is 1.732 minus 2, this is again giving me negative number, but then my square should always give me positive number, my square root. So I will rewrite this number also like this, 2 minus root 3 whole square, right? Now since this is giving positive, I can cancel out these two, right? Earlier you are doing mistake here, you're canceling out here directly, that shouldn't be done, that is the meaning here, right? So now your numbers are root 3 minus 1 plus 2 minus root 3. So your answer, cancel and cancel this one, your answer will be minus 1 plus 2, your answer will be 1, that's it. So your answer should be 1. I hope you understood now why exactly you got 1, right? Minus 1 is not the answer. Now solve this question. Starting the timer again, solve this one. I'll tell again. Again, mark this one, keep it to the end. I will explain it in the end again, right? Don't worry if you don't understand now. It's already been 1 hour, okay? So 1 hour is elapsed, but then still if people are still interested, we will continue. Yeah, people are still in the participant list, so we'll continue, right? Right, one, okay. So let's see. Now see here, he said, see the condition, this is very important. 2 is less than x is less than 3. So that means your x value is lying between 2 and 3. Right? Now see here. You have root of 2 minus x whole square. You said here it is said that x is greater than 2. Right? X is greater than 2 but less than 3. So if you perform 2 minus x, what you will get? You will get a negative number. Right? So you shouldn't actually do 2 minus x whole square. Write it as x minus 2 whole square. Fine. Now take this one. X is less than 3, that is already given there. X is less than 3, that means when x is less than 3, x minus 3 will give me negative result. Why? Because from smaller, this is smaller number, this is bigger number. Small minus big will give me negative number, right? So this also you have to rewrite as 3 minus x whole square. So write it as 3 minus x whole square. Now cancel the square root and this one. So x minus 2 plus 3 minus x. X and x will get cancelled. Minus 2 plus 3 will be plus 1. That's it. So your answer is 1. Okay. Right. That's what I said. Don't just square and do it. Okay. That's the subtle difference. People, that's why they fall in trap. Okay. Unless you know the exact meaning of square root, you will not be able to solve this question. That is the concept involved here, right? That's why I told you, you will square it and cancel. Don't cancel it that way. And again, you said anyway negative number will be there, we will square it, then it will become positive. That's what you are saying, right? But then what I'm saying is this number can be rewritten as when you change it, a minus b can written as b minus a, right? So you have to change that number. That means this number given here is not actually correct. You have to change the sign and make it proper and then go ahead with the calculation, right? Understood? Because square root should always give a positive result outside. So before going ahead, what you have to do is first make the number positive and continue. That's it. Now solve this one.